In the name of Allah, the gracious, the most merciful. Very, very good morning, students. Last time, we were discussing about monohybrid cross and Mendel's law of segregation. In this law, we have studied that the two coexisting alleles for each trait in an individual segregate from each other at meiosis, so that each gamete can receive only one of the two alleles. Alleles again unite at random fertilization of gametes when zygote is formed. Today we will discuss about the dihybrid and dihybrid cross. After thoroughly studying the inheritance of one trait, Mendel studied the inheritance of two traits simultaneously. And in this case, he crossed the two true breeding varieties. For example, seed shape and seed color. These are the two traits. Seed shape may be round or wrinkled. Round seed shape is dominant and wrinkled seed shape is recessive. Similarly, when we talk about the seed color, yellow seed color is dominant and ring and green seed color is recessive. Dominant character is represented by the capital letter, and recessive character is represented as small letter. And so, in this case, when he crossed the dye two traits simultaneously, he got the surprising results. And so, see over here, after thoroughly studying each trait separately, Mendel decided to study the inheritance of two traits simultaneously. The inheritance of two traits simultaneously. For example, seed shape and seed color. Last time, in his law of segregation, he only take one trait, round shape and wrinkled. True breeding round was crossed by the true breeding wrinkled. In F1 generation, all the plants we obtained were round seeded plants. But in this case, two traits are studied. Similarly, each seed color could be yellow or green. He crossed true breeding. He crossed true breeding round and yellow seed plants with the true breeding wrinkled and green seed plants. All F1 dihybrids were round and yellow. The wrinkled and green characteristics disappeared in F1 generation. As in the previous case, when we took only one character, only one trait, the seed shape, the round seed shape appeared in F1 generation, but in this case, round, yellow seed shape and seed color is appeared in F1 due to dominance, because round shape of the seed is dominant and wrinkle is recessive. Yellow color is dominant and green color is recessive. All F1 dihybrids were round and yellow. In F1, we got round and yellow due to dominance. Then he made the dihybrid cross by allowing self-fertilization. After this, Mendel self-fertilized of F1 progeny. F1 crossed with F1. The result was quite surprisingly. The result was, in F1 generation, all plants with round yellow seeds were obtained. There was no any wrinkled green seeded plants in F1 progeny. The result was quite surprising. Not only two parental combinations, that is round yellow and wrinkled green, but also two phenotypic combinations, two new phenotypic combinations, that is round green and wrinkled yellow, are produced, but in F2 dihybrids. In F2 dihybrids, when we cross F1 with F1, not only the parental types are obtained, but non-parental types, recombinant types also obtained. And so this was surprising. And so basically, this was due to dominance. See in the figure. When he crossed round yellow, which is true breeding variety, with the wrinkled green, he obtained F1 generation, first filial generation, and then he crossed F1 with F1. Round yellow seed plants were crossed with wrinkled green. Wrinkled green. Capital R, capital R, capital Y, capital Y. This capital R is for round shape of the seed. And capital Y is for yellow color of the seed. The capital letter is used for dominant, and recessive letter is used for recessive. And so at least two alleles represent one character. And so round character is represented by the capital R, and yellow character is represented by capital Y, capital Y. Similarly, for wrinkled, small R, small R, and for green, small Y, small Y. This is the P1, first parental generation, these are the genotypes, capital R, and capital R, capital Y, small r, small y, these are the genotypes. And so, gametes are formed during meiosis. In gametes, only one of the two alleles will come, will present. Capital R, capital Y, and small r, small y, these are the gametes. And when fertilization occurs, during fertilization, the male gamete and female gamete will unite together. We have taken round yellow seeded plant as male and wrinkled green seed plant as female. And so these are the male gametes and these are the female gametes. When they unite at fertilization, capital R, small r, and capital Y, small y, and this is the F1. This is the F1 generation. And so, this is round yellow. When this F1 generation is self-fertilized, F1 crossed with the F1, we get four combinations. Two parental combinations and two new combinations are recombinant phenotypes. And so, F1 crossed with F1, round yellow of F1 crossed with round yellow of F1. And so we get four combinations. This was the F2 generation. This will be F2 generation. Round yellow green wrinkled yellow and wrinkled green and when he count all these plants, the number will be round yellow ball, worth 305, round green ball 108, and wrinkled yellow ball 101, and wrinkled green ball 32. This is the F2 generation. This is the F2 generation. And these are the numbers. This is the F2 generation. And this is the number. And so, ratio will be 9 into 3 into 3 into 1. In F2 generation, the ratio was 9 into 3 into 3 into 1 of F2. This is the parental child, PT. This is also parental child. And these two are non-parental type, are recombinant types, recombinant phenotypes. And so, in this case, Mendel found that two new combinations also appeared. Round yellow and wrinkled, round green and wrinkled yellow. These two, round yellow and wrinkled green, were the parental combinations. And he concluded that during gamete formation, alleles are segregated. Similarly, there is shuffling of the trait also. Shuffling of the alleles as well as recombination of the traits takes place. Now, we will discuss about the Mendel's law of independent assortment. According to Mendel's law of independent assortment, two contrasting pairs of traits, when two contrasting pairs of traits are followed in the same class, their alleles assort independently. This law is based upon the dihybrid cross. In this case, Mendel crossed true breeding variety round yellow seed plants with the true breeding variety wrinkled green seed plants and obtained F1 and F2 generation. And so, in this case, when gametes are formed in the F2 generations, they assort independently. The capital R is not bound with the capital R, but it will combine with the small R also, as well as capital R is also combined with the capital Y and small y as well. Similarly, capital Y is combined with the small R or capital R. There is an equal chance to combine, and gametes segregate, separate and assort independently when two contrasting pairs of traits are followed in same class, their alleles assort independently into gametes. Mendel crossed true breeding round yellow seeded variety with the wrinkled green seed plants. When he crossed these two plants, their phenotype The phenotype for round yellow is capital R, capital capital R, capital R, capital Y, and for the wrinkled green plants, small R, small R, small Y, small Y. And so when gametes are formed, out of these two alleles, only one allele is present in the gamete. One capital R and one capital Y is present in the gametes, in all gametes. Similarly, in these small R, small R, only one allele is present, which is small R and small Y. Out of pair of alleles, small Y, only one allele, small Y, is present in the gamete. And so when these gametes unite at fertilization, and so round yellow plants are obtained. Capital R, small R, capital Y, small Y. These are the round yellow plants. Round yellow seeded plants. And so, in this case, we have observed that wrinkled as well as green character will be absent, is absent in this case. Because round character is dominant over wrinkled and yellow seed color is dominant over green. And so, in the F1 generation, recessive characters are masked, they disappear, and dominant characters appear. And so, round yellow, this is the wrinkled green, only one of the parents' phenotype will be obtained in the F1 generation, which is the round yellow. And when he got F2 generation, he crossed F1 generation with the F1. And so, F1 generation plants make their gametes. And so, these gametes assort independently of one another. See over here. For example, capital R, this is the capital R and this is the small R. This is the first trait. First alleles for the first trait. Alleles for first trait and capital Y, small Y, capital Y, small Y. These are the alleles for second trait. This is the method of gamete formation. And so, capital R, capital Y, capital R, small Y, small R, capital Y, small R, small Y. These four types of the gametes are formed. And so, in this case, we have observed that there is independent assortment of the alleles into gametes. And so, these gametes, ratio of these gametes is 1 into 1 into 1 into 1. And so, this is the ratio 1, 1, 1, 1. Ratio. And so, when F1 is crossed with F1, and so, male parent produces male gametes. These are the male gametes. And female parent produces the female gametes. And so, when he got the F2 generation, F2 progeny, total 16 combinations were obtained. In these 16 combinations, parental combinations are also present and recombinant types are also present in the ratio of 9 into 3 into 3 into 1. And how this occur? When we multiply across, these are the male gametes and these are the female gametes, we obtain the capital R, capital Y, small y. This will unite with this. This can, then this gamete will unite with this gamete, and so on. And so we have total 16 combinations. And so now we see what are the phenotypes. What are the parental and non-parental phenotypes? Four types of the combinations were got in this case. Firstly, round, yellow, round yellow, this is the round yellow, this is the round yellow, this is the round yellow. Similarly, this is also round yellow and this is also round yellow. When one dominant allele is present, it will show itself, and the recessive allele shows itself when it is present in homozygous form. When the two recessive alleles are present, they show their self. And if one dominant allele is present and one recessive allele is present, dominant allele shows itself and recessive allele will be masked by the dominant allele. And so in this case, we obtain round yellow 9, round green 3, wrinkled yellow 3, these are also 3, and similarly wrinkled green. Wrinkled green phenotype is 1. And so we obtain the phenotypic ratio 9 into 3 into 3 into 1. And so ratio 9 into 3 into 3 into 1. In this case, this is the parental type and round yellow is parental type. Similarly, wrinkled green is also parental type, but these two, round green and wrinkled green, they are the recombinant types or non-parental types. Recombinant types. In this case, we observe that during gamete formation, alleles are independently assorted. Similarly, characters are also independently assorted. Round character is not bound with yellow And winter crater is not bound with green. Round shape may be present with the green color. Similarly, wrinkled shape of the seed will also be present with the yellow. And so, four types of the combinations are obtained. And so, this is due to the shuffling of the alleles during the gamete formation. And so, this is the round green. This is also round green. And this is also round green. And round green 3. And then we will find out wrinkled yellow. This is the wrinkled yellow, this is also wrinkled yellow, and this is also wrinkled yellow. Only one plant which is the wrinkled green when we talk about the ratio. And he counted the total plants, round yellow seeded plants were 305, round green were 108, wrinkled yellow were 101, and wrinkled green were 32 plants. And so Mendel was very intelligent person. He applied mathematics as well as statistics, and he properly counted the progeny, the plants, when he studied his breeding experiments. When he performed his breeding experiments, he was very careful in counting the number of seeds as well as the number of plants. And so, the Mendel's success is present in this case also, that he studied one pair of traits at a time, and after studying the monohybrids, then he studied the dihybrids, and so he presented his laws. And these laws are very, very important. They are the classical laws. They are the basis for the inheritance. And so Mendel is called father of genetics. Thank you very much.